Let's continue looking at some other variables so we can better understand our users and our sample data set. This time, I'm going to examine the distribution of tenure, or how many days someone has been using Facebook. I'm also going to start introducing color to jazz up our plots a little bit. To do that, I'm going to use the color and the fill parameter. Now, I'm not going to explain this code in detail. Check out the instructor notes for an explanation of this code. There's also a link to ggplot's themes to learn about all the different adjustments besides color that you can make. Now, if this code is throwing you for a loop, I don't want you to focus on it too much. You can really just ignore it. I'll typically include it as the second line of parameters inside of qplot. Running this code, we can see we get a nice histogram. And again, here the histogram has defaulted to an automatic bin width. I'm going to make one last adjustment and set it for ourselves. By setting the bin width equal to 30, we can see we get a finer view of the distribution. Let's see if you have a handle on histograms and bin width. We're going to see if you can change the distribution in this next programming exercise. In it, you're going to be creating a histogram of tenured that's measured in years rather than in days. You'll also want to think about an appropriate bin width for the data. 30 here makes sense since I'm measuring days, and 30 days is about a month.